Hello, how are you?
Our star of the day. Hello, doctor.
Hello, Dr.
Nice
Victor.
to see you.
Very nice to see you. How are you today? It's almost New Year.
Yes,
we are happy.
Thank you. Thank you. We wish you a happy new year. And we have some of esteemed panelists here. If you are ready to start, we can then just announce the panel and we are ready to go. Okay?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay. Okay. Let me then just, we are already live, so I will just go on and try to introduce the panel. Dr. Hadi is here, but I'm not sure if he can hear us now. If you can, Dr. Hadi, could you please introduce yourself? If not, I will introduce Dr. Hadi. He's a neurosurgeon from Iraq who is a senior and a training neurosurgeon there. I mean, who is training other neurosurgeons. So really a great addition to our panelists. We also have here Armando from, can you please introduce yourself?
Hi everyone, I'm Armando Soriano. I'm from Cochabamba, Bolivia. I'm a student of medicine of fifth year, and I love neurology and neuroscience and neurosurgery, and thank you for these lectures.
Hope to see you there in Cochabamba next year.
Oh, you will be.
Yeah, there will be a meeting, the Latin American Congress of Neurological Surgeons.
Oh.
Yeah, in Cochabamba next year. I think it's going to be held in September or October. Yeah, I see you here.
I will go.
Yeah.
That is a great announcement to make. So thank you, Dr. Perez, for mentioning it. Also, we have here Dr. Nguyen from, I hope I pronounce it right, from Vietnam. Can you please introduce yourself?
Yes, hello. I'm Dr. Nguyen Dinh from Hanoi, Vietnam. I'm a neurosurgeon. Yes, it's second time for my sister this video call, and my pleasure. Thank you.
Nice to meet you in this conference.
Nice to meet you.
And we also have our longtime favorite Rakesh AV here, doctor from India, a neurosurgical resident. Please introduce yourself. Rakesh, welcome.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. First of all, wish you all a very happy new year. And I'm again very glad to be a part of this neuroanatomy series from a great neuroanatomist, Dr. Victor. I myself, Dr. Rakesh, I'm a neurosurgery resident from India.
Thank you. Nice to meet you. Yeah, we are going to talk about the surgical anatomy of this region. As you know, most of the lesions in this region are petrochloral meningiomas, and they really present a challenge for neurosurgeons because of their deep seated locations and proximity to critical neurovascular structures. So we are going to make a review about the surgical vascular and neural structures that we find in this kind of lesions in this region, the petrochloral region. So do you see the cursor? The cursor, yeah?
Rakesh,
yes,
can you
we can see the cursor. Yes, I can see the cursor.
Okay.
Nice improvement from last week.
Okay, here we have the supraclinoid carotid artery, the left side and right side. Optic nerves, tear nerves, basilar artery, and the posterior communicating arteries. So the petrochloral region involves this region, particularly this region. We can see in there the posterior cerebral artery, the third cranial nerve, the fourth cranial nerve, and another small arteries. In the pre-surgical preparation of the patient, we should know that we could find an special venous network. So I want to show you this video. Let me diminish the volume. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. Then we can see the video. Thank you. We also see the cursor.
Okay, what's the reason I'm showing you this video? You know, if you are going to make an approach, a transpetrous approach, you should know in a preoperative study, X-ray study, or vascular study, how do you have these small veins? This is the labae vein, and you should know if this labae venous has a good anastomosis with the Sylvian vein or another vein. For example, in this picture, you can see a very nice anastomosis between this Sylvian fissure and this labae vein. So what could happen in this kind of approach? If you lesion this small vein, labae vein, you could have a temporal infarct, a venous hemorrhage infarct, because you don't have a good anastomosis. But if you have a good anastomosis like here, is the probability to have a venous infarct is diminishes. So let's go to see this video again. It's a nice video. This is an injection of the venous system with silicone. This is the labae venous. So labae venous, labae vein is located posteriorly in the almost in the temporal occipital junction. So this labae vein has a very good anastomosis between the Sylvian vein and also the trollar vein. So you can see in this brain, this brain doesn't have a good connection between those veins. So in the skull base, the petrochlival region is this. So here we have the cellar region, the posterior clinoid process, the third nerve, optic nerve, oculomotor nerve, the very, very small fourth nerve, the sixth nerve, and the trigeminal nerve. This is the Kawase approach. Maybe you note the difference between this region and this other region. Here we have an osseous tumor, an osteoma. This is a fissure in the postmortem case. So in this other skull base, we have the superior petrosal sinus and the inferior petrosal sinus. This is the sigmoid sinus and the transverse sinus. So sometimes also, if you are going to make the approach in the in the anterior petrosal approach or transpetrosal, you have to work with this superior petrosal sinus. Sometimes you can see a very small superior petrosal sinus, and other times you could have some problems with this superior petrosal sinus because they are of greater size. So this is the Kawase's triangle. So let's go to see this picture. This is a really nice picture because you can see a very nice anastomosis between the Sylvian vein with the Labé vein. In the transpetrosal approach, you cannot separate the temporal bone, the temporal lobe of the brain more than 1 centimeter. So you are going to work with a very, very small, space between the skull base and the temporal lobe. So if you displace the temporal lobe more than 1 centimeter, the risk of broke this vein is really high. So here we have another brain that was injected with blue color and red color for arteries and blue color for veins, and we have a very nice anastomosis between the Labé vein with the Sylvian vein. So in this picture, we can see the structures, the arterial, venous, and nerve elements that we have to work with. So for example, here we have the supracinous carotid artery, the posterior communicating artery, and the posterior cerebral artery. This is the third cranial nerve, the oculomotor, and supracerebellar artery. This is the tip of the basilar artery. So maybe you have to work also with this cistern, the ambience cistern. So in this ambience cistern, you are going to find the trochlear nerve and the third cranial nerve. This is the superior cerebellar artery, and this is the posterior cerebral artery. Let's go to see this video. Look at this. I am retracting the temporal lobe in order to see the ambient cistern. So here we have the basilar of the tip of the basilar artery, the P1 of the right side, and P1 in the left side. They are really, really small. The posterior communicating artery that is coming from the supracinous carotid artery is greater than the P1. So this is a variant known as fetal variant. So let's go to see again. Look at this. This is the posterior communicating artery that is giving rise to the posterior cerebral artery, P1. And which nerve is this? Could you tell me which nerve is this?
Third nerve.
So, excuse me?
Third nerve.
This is the trochlear nerve. This one is the trochlear nerve. It's the smaller of the cranial nerves, and this is a third nerve. The third nerve always is always passes between the posterior cerebral artery and superior cerebellar artery. Always this nerve is passing between these arteries. So look at this. I am retracting the temporal lobe in order to see these structures. So let's go to see the posterior cerebral artery with some branches, and here we have an special arteries that are giving rise the irrigation to the pineal gland. This is the mesencephalon, nigra substance nigra, and mammillary bodies, optic nerves, optic chiasm, and the posterior cerebral artery. This is known as the uncus of the temporal lobe. So here we have another brain, another specimen. We can see the trochlear, ocular motor nerves. So this third nerve is always always goes between these arteries. This is the posterior cerebral artery, and this is known as the superior cerebellar artery. Yeah, you are right. And these small arteries are known as the posterior communicating arteries. As you can see, these arteries are smaller than the posterior cerebral artery. This is the most common presentation of these arteries. So in here we can see also the middle cerebral arteries, the other one, and this lenticular straight arteries. So here we have the anterior communicating artery and A2, the anterior cerebral artery in the A2 segment, right and left. Which other structures can I see here? So do you recognize this small nerve? This is the
fourth
trochlear nerve. And let's go to see this nerve. This is the fourth cranial nerve, this one. The superior cerebral artery. Okay. In this kind of tumors, it's very important that you should to identify these nerve, these neural structures and the arteries. Let's go to see this video. I'm going to open the ambient cistern. Look at the fourth cranial nerve. The complications of this kind of surgery is the lesion of some cranial nerves. I think the fourth cranial nerve because of its size, is one of the most damaged nerves in this kind of surgery. So despite surgical advances and the usual benign history of lesions in this region, the incidence of permanent cranial nerve deficits has been shown to vary from 20 to almost 80% in a number of series. So let's go to see this slide. This is really, really nice. First, we should recognize some structures in this size. So this is known as basilar artery.
Basilar artery.
Okay. This is if we have in this region the third cranial nerve. This artery is known as posterior cerebral artery. But then after this, we should identify some things in these variants. So this is the superior cerebellar artery, and this artery. What's the name of this artery? It's not common.
Ica.
That is spica, yeah.
No.
Ica.
Anterior inferior. Yeah.
No. This artery is is very, very, very uncommon, and this artery was cut because this artery is going to the cavernous to the cavernous sinus. So this is known as trigeminal fetal persistent trigeminal artery. Have you heard about this artery?
Yeah. Yeah.
This is
the most common persistent variant.
Yeah, it's very uncommon, but this is a persistent fetal trigeminal artery. So let's back to this ray on the tip of the basilar artery. Here we have the posterior cerebral artery and the other posterior cerebral artery. Let's go to see what's happening in this. So here we have a very small branches known as the mesencephalic arteries. So you were going to ask something, excuse me?
Yes, Rakesh. Did you have some questions, Rakesh?
Yes. So sorry to interrupt. Can you go to the previous slide, please, sir? Where is anterior inferior cerebellar artery in that? So is that missing over there or
this one?
Anterior inferior cerebellar artery in this?
Yes, ICA. Where is ICA?
ICA.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So is it visible here or?
Okay. ICA is this one, and ICA, could be one of these. But okay. In other presentation, I want to show you some trigeminal arteries that I have found in this kind of. Brains. This brain has too many variants, as you can see in the basilar tip. This is a very uncommon presentation of this arterial network. So, then after we can talk about these variants of the posterior cerebral arteries. So. Here we have the tip of this basilar artery, the superior cerebral artery, posterior cerebral artery, and let's go to see what will happen in this. Okay, this is a meningioma. that is very big. So this lesion occupies the anterior, middle, and some of the posterior fossil cranium. So here we have the petroclival region, and in the surgery we should have many. You should have so many care in the removal of these kind of lesions. You should know that there are the arteries could be involved in these kind of lesions. So recently, most surgeons have tended to move away from radical resection to preservation of quality of life. Moreover, the availability of stereotactic radiosurgery has been associated with excellent tumor growth control and progression-free survival rates with a long-term follow-up. So in the surgery, you should take care with the arteries and nerves. So here I am resecting this giant lesion, and in the final of the removal, so here we have a very thin supraclinal carotid artery with the anterior and middle arteries. So in here you could see this supraclinal carotid artery. Okay. And this is the pre and post-operative result. The rates of gross total resection vary widely from 20% to 85%. Reflecting differing philosophies in management and surgical aggressiveness of these kind of lesions. So we should take care with the removal of these lesions, because we could have an important nerve or arterial lesion. So the quality of life is important for the patient. So here we have some horizontal cuts of the brain. Here in Mexico, I am working with some special staining of this kind of brain. So this is the Mulligan staining, in which you can stain the gray substance. The gray substance convert to a blue color. All what you can see in this slide in color blue is the gray substance, and the white is the same color. Gray substance and white substance. If you want to identify some structures, it's much better to stain the brain. We can get this kind of result. So here we have a slide that shows the arteries related with the petroclival region. So as you can see, here we have the superior cerebellar artery, the posterior cerebral artery, the tip of the basilar artery, the trigeminal nerve. This could be the fourth cranial nerve, this one, and the third cranial nerve is over here. I think this third cranial nerve was cut. So here we have the sixth cranial nerve, trigeminal, fourth, the theory cranial nerve could be this, yes. And it was cut very shortly. So here we have the mammillary bodies and the uncus of the temporal bone. Here we have another picture. This is the third cranial nerve, oculomotor nerves in both sides, the hypophysis, the infundibulum, the superior, the carotid arteries, optic nerves, the A2, A1 segment of the anterior cerebral artery, the anterior communicating artery, the tip of the basilar artery, superior cerebral arteries, and the uncus of the temporal lobes. So this is another nice, another beautiful picture. So could you tell me with which structure we are seeing in here?
If I can see this well, it looks
this,
like
in the this is a gland. This is the pineal gland.
A pineal gland. Uh-huh.
Pineal gland. Yeah, it's really beautiful, and the artery that is giving rise, that is irrigating this pineal gland, is the posterior choroidal, the medial posterior choroidal artery, that is coming from the posterior cerebral artery. So this artery is really really nice. I'm going to. To show you this this is the pineal gland, and these small arteries are coming from the posterior cerebral artery. This is known as the medial posterior choroidal artery. Okay. Okay, let's make an exercise. Here we have some arteries, and I'd like you to identify some of them. This is the
basilar artery.
Basilar artery. Okay, right. This one.
Superior cerebellar artery.
Yes. Perfect. Superior cerebellar artery. You can identify this because of the origin of the third cranial nerve. Inferiorly is the superior, and superiorly is the posterior cerebral artery. And which is this region?
Fourth
cranial nerve. And the mammillary bodies, this is the right third cranial nerve, the left third cranial nerve, and this one?
That is middle cerebral artery.
Middle cerebral artery, and this is small arteries.
These are lenticular stride.
Yeah, okay, perfect. And here we have this structure is? This is a part of the thalamus. The lateral genu body.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And if this is the lateral geniculate ganglion, this one, this artery is the anterior choroidal artery. Anterior choroidal artery. So this one is.
Okay. That is this what is it? Olfactory strain.
Olfactory strain. Yes. Okay. Right. Okay. This is the same view. So for cranial nerve, so, third cranial nerve. Excuse me.
Sorry to interrupt. Anterior coronal artery is coming from. Can you show the? It's a branch of anterior coronal artery.
Anterior choroidal artery is a branch from the supraclinoid carotid artery. The supraclinoid carotid artery is giving rise to three arteries. First one is the ophthalmic, and then the posterior communicating artery, and then the anterior choroidal artery.
Okay.
Here we have the optic nerve divides in the optic nerve, chiasma, and scintilla optica, the optic, this is the
optic tract maybe? Tract?
Optic tract, yes. The optic tract is going to the, to this, lateral geniculate
body. Okay.
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
LGB.
Okay. LGB. Let's see this, the optic tract, and then the lateral geniculate body. So, okay. This is the cavernous sinus. So let's go to see some structures in here. Here we have the lateral aspect of the cavernous sinus, the optic nerve, the supraclinoid carotid artery, the anterior clinoidal process, third cranial nerve, fourth cranial nerve, here we have the inferolateral artery of the intracavernous carotid artery. This is the sixth cranial nerve. I am displacing in here the trigeminal nerve. Petrolingual ligament and the Ruber's ligament. This is the posterior clinoid process. Laterally, here we have the Kawase's triangle that was removed, and here we have the intrapetrous carotid segment. So in here we have the cochlear nerve, and here we have the semicircular channels. So I'd like you to see again this without voice to recognize these elements. Okay. Okay, this is the cochlear nerve. Semicircular channels, the superior, posterior, lateral. Here we have the middle ear with the ear ossicles. So let's try again. Okay. Can you see this?
We can. Okay.
Let's go again with this. So, can you see it?
Yes, it was all right. Okay. For me. Okay. Rakesh, can you see it? Okay, yes. You can proceed.
Okay.
Yes.
Here we have the cochlear nerve, the semicircular channels, and the ear ossicles. Okay, let's go to see this other video. So I put some plast in here in order to displace the cranial nerves. So I like you not pay attention with this. I think it's not the better. It's not the best to put this kind of plast to displace the nerve, but I didn't have other options when I did this dissection. So here we have the Ruber's ligament, the sixth cranial nerve, the Kawase's triangle. In the Kawase's triangle, here we have the intrapetrous segment of the carotid artery, and here we have the vestibular cochlear nerve and the facial nerve. Okay, let's go to see another picture. So here we have some elements of the cavernous sinus: third cranial nerve, fourth cranial nerve, fifth cranial nerve, and look at this. This is a really, really nice picture, because we can see the inferolateral artery of the cavernous carotid artery. So this small artery irrigates the cranial nerves. In here we have the meningohypophyseal trunk with the McConnell artery, with the this could be the hypophyseal inferior artery, the meningeal dorsal artery, and the posterior and the Bernasconi caseinari arteries. Here we have the fourth arteries that are coming from the meningohypophyseal trunk. One, two, three, and four small arteries. This is the venous in this region. So can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
The meningohypophyseal trunk, the sixth cranial nerve. This is the sixth cranial nerve, and here we have the inferolateral artery of the cavernous carotid artery. So here we have the sixth, third. No, third is in the upper side. This is the fifth and sixth cranial nerves. So just remember that this triangle is known as the Parkinson's triangle. So let's go to see this other here we have the basilar tip of the tip of the basilar artery. Here we have the posterior cerebral artery. So look to this brain. We don't have a connection and anastomosis between the posterior cerebral artery and with P1. This is P1, and P1 is not giving rise to the posterior cerebral artery, because this is a fetal variant of the posterior communicating artery. And here we have the superior cerebral artery, and in the left side we can see a P1, the left P1, superior cerebral artery, and the posterior communicating artery. This is not a common variant. This is rare a rare variant of the branches of the basilar artery. These arteries are the mesencephalic perforator arteries. So doing a dissection of the arteries of the brain, we could have some surprises. So as you can see in here, to understand this picture, you should recognize first of all the third cranial nerve. This is the third cranial nerve. So if this is the third cranial nerve, okay, superior cerebellar artery. Okay, you are right. And if this is the superior cerebellar artery, this is the
basilar artery.
Basilar artery, right. Okay. And this is, if this small artery, posterior communicating artery. Okay, perfect. So when I did this dissection, I saw this small artery, and I didn't pay attention to this artery. I didn't pay too much attention to this artery. I recognized this as a very small posterior communicating artery with a small fenestration. But look, this artery when I cut the brain. So it's really impressive what I found in this small artery. Look at this. This is the posterior communicating artery. This is the fenestration of this very, very small posterior communicating artery. And look at this. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, probably nine arteries coming from this very small posterior communicating artery. Let's go to see again this artery. Okay, again, the basilar artery, right superior cerebral artery, left superior cerebral artery, P1 in the left side, P1 in the right side. This is the posterior cerebral artery coming from the supraclinoid carotid artery. So this artery is known as fetal variant of the posterior communicating artery. So this is P1. Okay, and then we are going to see this beautiful, very beautiful arteries that are coming from the posterior, from the P1, from P1. This is P1 in the right side. So look the branches of this artery, mesencephalic arteries, third cranial nerve, this and this. Okay, let's go to see this video. The tip of the basilar artery, superior cerebellar, in the left side, in the right side. This is P1 in the left side and P1 in the right side. Look these perforators arteries, the third cranial nerve, interpeduncular fossa, and the mammillary bodies. Let's go to see again this without sound. Okay. Is there any question? Is there any question?
Is there any question from the panel? You can ask questions now. Yes, Rakesh seems to.
No. Unmute. I'm just enjoying the lecture. Is it? I hope the lecture is still on or completed.
Okay, thank you. So I'm going to. Okay, hope you like it. Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, Dr. Victor. Amazing okay. Presentation once again.
No, thanks. Thanks again.
Indeed, we love the pictures. We just love the stunning pictures. Now I think I'll. It's a great competition to Rothan.
No, thank you so much.
So it's amazing. It's amazing. I really love your pictures.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And we hope to see many more of these, which is actually very needed and very basic for all the approaches. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
This is Dr. Perez, it was another great lecture. I think that this time you included more of neurosurgical images and some of the pearls of technique, which I really liked. So I think that, and also this quiz section was very good for us to kind of to exercise what we learned during your lecture. So I think this is a great addition in your series, and we hope that we will continue the next weekend as well, because you really, I think you are now, for now really having a spree of lectures, which are great and really viewed. We have lots of viewers online and here on the panel as well. So we're really thankful to you for your time. I would also like to say that we have another panelist here. It's Marco, who is part of the team for a long time. So maybe Marco, if you can introduce yourself.
Hi, everybody. My name is Marco Antonio. I'm from Bolivia. It was an excellent presentation.
Hello, Marco.
Hi, Rakesh. How are you?
Hello. Long time. I've been talking to you over Facebook. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Yes, and Marco is also in Cochabamba, I think, Bolivia. Yeah. Dr. Perez mentioned that he's coming there for a symposium.
Yes, it's right. I'm from Cochabamba, Bolivia. Yes. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
This is going to be a neuroanatomy symposium, Dr. Perez.
No, we are going to have the Latin American Congress in the next year is going to be in Cochabamba, Bolivia. The Latin American Neurosurgical Society is going to organize this Congress.
This is a big event. Well,
yes.
It is. I just wanted to know.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Rakesh, please.
Sorry.
Please, Rakesh.
I just wanted to know from Dr. Victor that any. Do you know any conferences which just anatomy, I think you might be knowing, like just neuroanatomy conferences.
Excuse me again. I did not understand.
Any neuroanatomy conferences? A conference just dedicated to neuroanatomy?
No. I am going to participate in this TB neurosurgical studies. So I don't know how many time, but what I can tell you is that I have too many specimens of spinal human cords and also brains. So I have found so many variants, anatomical variants, that I want to show you with videos, with photos, and everything.
We would be glad to see everything of them.
Thank you so much.
Hope to see you more, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, I hope to see you too, Dr. Rakesh. Thanks for your comments.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, and again, if there are no more questions, then we can maybe conclude this session for today. We saw two great presentations from Professor Hernesniemi and one from Dr. Perez, which is really another strong one with lots of viewers. What I would like to emphasize, both online and here on the panel, and again, what can I say? Thank you so much, Professor Perez, for you and for your time, even on the old year, depending on the time of the earth, you are working so to improve our knowledge, and we are really grateful to you. So we would like to wish you a happy new year with lots of success in it, and lots of hangouts from all of us at Neurosurgical TV and from all around the world, because all around the world was listening to you. So thank you very much. Also, all of the panelists, and thank you so much for participating.
Thank you. Thank you, Slavin. And I want you to also very, I like you to have a very happy new year. So we are going to work very, very hard this this 2018 year.
Yes, thank you. We have also a new year wishes from Dr. Hadi, who had to go, he wrote, and also from Dr. Nguyen. So thank you so much. I think this concludes this year perfectly. And for me, it's already as it is, like it is new year. So thank you so much. I'm so happy that this was the way to enter it. Okay,
okay.
So
see you.
We will stop broadcasting.